This is the tech follow-up of the GMBN video where I actually tried a bigger wheel in my Scott Genius. I ran a 29 up front, a 27.5 plus in the rear. If you've not seen that video already, I'll check that out before you watch this. But also I've done a video in the past of me trying out 29s on both front and rear and 27.5. So lots of different variations here. Today I'm talking about running a 29 up front, 27.5 rear, and I'm gonna get in some of those stats about the bike. So the Scott Genius is designed to run either size wheel, and all you need to do is flip the chip between the two to try and keep the angles about the same. I'm lucky enough to have two pairs of wheels for this bike, and they're both identical. The DT Swiss with the M1825 rim, both of them are 30mm wide, so that shouldn't affect the tyre profile too much between the different sizes. Of course, on the Plus, I've actually got a 2.6 inch tyre. On the 29, it's just a 2.4, so it's narrower up front and also not as deep as the rear tyre. It is really easy to swap the wheels on these ones. They've got centre lock rotor, so all I need to do is whip that off, change it over, and then change the cassette. I've got tyres on, so it's quite an easy thing to do. Is it practical to do it all the time? I guess it is. It's going to be expensive if you want two pairs of wheels. So the thing you do need to do on the Genius when you're moving between wheel sizes is actually flip that chip on that shock linkage. Super easy to do. All you do is undo the bolt and then turn them around and put them back in. And what that does is it keeps the geometry really similar between the wheel sizes. So it's 65 degree head angle on the 29 wheels, and it's 65.6 on 27.5. So when I messed around and put a smaller wheel in the back, it actually went down to a 64.2 head angle. So pretty slack, that's getting towards downhill bike that is. And the BB went to 332 millimeters. So for me, that is the biggest compromise on that setting with it in the low. It just felt like it was too low. I'm gonna start clipping my pedals on more technical terrain. So I flipped it over and then I rode it. It did feel much more balanced. So actually the head angle went back to a 64.8, so you know, almost 65. The BB angle, BB height went up to 336, so I actually only changed 4 millimeters, but that did make enough difference to me to make the bike feel like that's how I'd wanna ride it if I was gonna do this setup. So the first geometry values I gave you are all from the Scott website, so they're official numbers. When it comes to messing around with the wheels and finding the other numbers, I've actually used a tape measure and I've borrowed Doddy's Wixie digital angle gauge. I don't have one of these because you need a nerd certificate to get one of these, and I'm afraid I don't have one. So that does mean the numbers are a little bit approximate, but that is how it feels to me. The bike does feel a little bit slacker, a little bit lower. Also, the ride difference does feel, you know, basically you've got more volume in that rear tire, so that does make a difference, as I talk about in the video. It's those little bumps, so when you're riding over little stones and edges and things like that, that bigger volume means it's a bit more compliant, so through my feet I felt less bumps. And then it's the same thing really with a bigger wheel on the front. I guess I've got a thinner tire, so less volume, but the bigger wheel has more rollover. Like I talked about in the last tech video, I got the two different tapes out to show them rolling over that tool. The bigger tape will actually roll over a little bit easier. So that does mean it makes it a little bit easier on my wrists up front. What I'm really doing is mixing up the advantages and disadvantages of both wheels. So let's talk about advantages first. Front wheel, greater rollover. Rear wheel, I've got more compliance and I've got a bit more grip in certain situations, and it's a lighter wheel than the bigger tire. Disadvantages, heavier wheel on the front. And also, when we talk about the actual sort of tread of that tire, one thing I find with Plus tires, I talk about this quite a lot, is in the wet, they can float a little bit. They don't dig in quite as well as a thinner tire does. And on really hard packed dirt, you can find that you have to run quite high pressures, otherwise you'll be rolling that tire around quite a lot. So all in all, is it a good idea to mix them up? For me, jury is still out. Today, the test was really wet. Although it was still quite grippy, it was so wet, the mud was so thin. But I think I need to try out again, and actually I think I need to put some times to it. But on the trail, how much difference did I actually feel? Surprisingly, not a huge amount, to be honest. In the past, for racing enduro on a bike like this, I've actually run a heavier weight tire on the rear, or an insert like a Schwalbe Procore, because I find that I more often than not get punctures on the rear. And also I give that rear wheel a lot of punishment so I can ding the rim. So it did feel a little bit like that. I've got more air volume there, so it just feels like that rear wheel is more protected. I'm not getting as much feedback through my feet. Feels slightly heavier, even though it's not. That rear tire and rear wheel setup is actually lighter than the 29er. So I don't know, it's a hard one to tell really. I think I need to test it more, like I said, but is it actually worth it? I don't know. Is it the future of mountain bikes? Probably not. The big problem here is the UCI. So when it comes to racing bikes, you've got to have the same size wheels front and rear. Obviously, this isn't a downhill bike, it doesn't count for that. You're not gonna race cross country on it. Enduro isn't UCI regulated, so we could see it. I'm just not sure if the bike manufacturers are gonna get on board with it. So it's been nice to test this out. Will I keep riding my bike like this? Probably not, to be honest. I like this bike with 29 inch wheels, so I'll be chucking that back on. I also think there's a bit of a practicality issue of having spare. So are you gonna carry two spare tires everywhere? Tubes, not so much of an issue. I'll let you into a little secret here. 26 inch tubes will fit anything. They'll pump up and fill it. So that's not a massive issue, but I think I'm just gonna go back to riding 29. Leave us your questions if you've got any down below. I'm sure you've got some good ones. So what I'll do is I'll try and answer those in the dirt shed next week. Also, if you've not seen the original video of me riding this bike like this, click up there for that one. Give us a thumbs up if you like the style of video. And like I say, keep leaving those comments.